Have you seen this man? Deep in your basement, hiding in the shadows, lurking, planning, waiting for the day of his release? You probably haven't. Why has this demon entered your basement? Why can you sometimes hear whispers of former Canadian Prime Minister Stephen Harper, the numbers going up, and why the hell has the $10 Pizza Hut dinner box almost doubled in price? That's real, by the way, look it up. This creature used to be just like you until it made the mistake of clicking on the most painful idle game known to humankind. This creature is me. Welcome to the focus of my everyday life for the past 4 months. No, I am not kidding. How did we get to this point? It started innocently enough. I've completed a couple clicker and idle games in my time and wanted to add another one to my completionist belt. Steam happily recommended NGU Idle, claiming it to be a free-to-play idle game with some achievements to get to, and so I happily bound this virus to my Steam account, put it on my computer, and started playing. And in doing so on February 3rd at 5:17 p.m. Central Time, I opened the figurative Pandora's box, forever changing my life and transforming me into the creature you fear today. What do you even do in NGU Idle? As you can imagine, NGU stands for Numbers Go Up, which is the only objective you have in this fuck-ass game. You start with next to nothing, some attack, defense, health, and two menus. Basic Training, where you can allocate your increasing energy to the growth of attack or defense, and Fight Boss, where you fight the boss. Life-changing. The more energy you have, the more you can allocate to basic training and later features to grow your stats. The more stats you have, the more bosses you can kill. The more bosses you kill, the more experience you get to upgrade your energy. The more energy and power that you have, the stronger you will become and the closer you will get to supreme victory. But wait, a new feature just got unlocked. Adventure Mode. Now, as your attack and defense idly increase, you can embark to adventure zones and battle monsters, gain perks, and conquer boss titans. Earn gold to throw away in this decrepit hole. Wear the flesh of your defeated foes as a fashion statement. At this point, you may start to notice a slight pain in the back of your head. Your attack and defense might be slowing down. It's taking longer and longer to defeat each boss. The numbers are barely going up now.
Why are we still here? Just to suffer?
No. Rejoice, my child, for it's time to rebirth. In exchange for all of the progress you just made, you can reset your run to make that number go up. What's that at the bottom? Don't worry about it. Number is a multiplier to your attack and defense. The more you nurture your number, the more your power will grow. And so, you have no choice but to regularly submit to the developer, sacrificing everything you've worked so hard for in order to inch closer to supreme victory. I have a date with this game in 20 minutes, so I'm gonna go a little faster now. Augmentation. Spend gold and energy to upgrade your physical body with game-changing weapons like macaroni guns, directly multiplying your attack and defense. Magic. Instead of green, this energy is blue. Everything from this point on requires both energy and magic to grow. I think I'm having an aneurysm. Time Machine. Takes the highest gold drop you've earned this rebirth and duplicates the ever-loving shit out of it directly into your pocket. Blood Magic. With your blue energy, cast advertiser-friendly spells to extract blood for increasing your number, gold, stats, or drop chance. Oh yeah, did I mention drop chance? Don't worry about it. Hopefully it won't bother you when 2 billion percent drop chance actually means 0.5%. That's real. NGUs. It's in the game. And the best feature, in my objectively correct opinion, because you use it to make all of your numbers go up permanently, even your number. It's great. It sure would be awful if this feature got taken away for some reason. Yggdrasil is a big ass tree. carefully cultivate various flavors of fruit over the course of 24 real-time hours just to smear shit on them before consumption. Doing this grants temporary and permanent stat increases. Hope you like logging in daily because this feature essentially forces 24-hour rebirth cycles. Gold diggers. Don't know what to do with the gigafillions of gold you're earning every second? Pay these rat dudes your surplus for more stat and speed increases when you need them. Beards. Use your excess energy generation to collect all 7 of the Dragon Balls. The Fu Manchu. The Neck Beard.
Look here! Look!
The Reverse Hitler. The Beard Cage. The Lady Beard. The Beard. And the Golden Beard. Questing. Does the sound of babysitting your inventory for an hour fill you with glee? Then you'll love this feature. Comply with the very hungry caterpillar's demands for food in exchange for quirks. They're like adventure perks, except... yeah, they're just more perks. Hacks. These are really slow NGUs, but with really slow orange energy. Oh, great, now there's a third energy bar to make. And then 3 more fun-filled features I can't even touch on, because I haven't reached them yet after playing this game optimally for over 1,800 hours. But let's not forget challenges. Do you love CBT, micromanagement, malding, and stomach ulcers? Yes? Look no further than these fuckified rebirths that completely reset your number, temporarily disable features, and disable offline idling. Did I mention these are borderline required to progress? Have fun. I'm actually gonna die.
How do you even beat this game?
Well, I think Satan takes credit. Once you complete NGU Idle, the rug gets pulled out from under you because you actually haven't accomplished dick. Remember those little buttons at the bottom of the rebirth screen? Yep, these are glorified prestige rebirths that, you guessed it, reset your number to 0 and amplify the living hell out of this game's pain factor. To top it off, completion of sadistic mode can literally take years, plural, and is required to earn the final achievement in this game. And so we come to the final question. What the hell is NGU Idle? Let me tell you. NGU Idle is a secret government psyop disguised as a video game, feeding us dopamine a la growing numbers in order to suppress the truth and scientifically determine the exact breaking point of completionists like me. But I will not break. I will beat this fucking raid boss of Idle Games, or I will die trying.
And we can do it together. It's gonna take effort. It's going to take patience. It's going to take a lot and a lot of work. But if we don't try, then what the fuck is stopping us from just throwing ourselves off a bridge and giving up and saying, yeah, the planet is dying, the government hates us, the animals are leaving, the aliens aren't contacting us, we might be alone, it just might be you and me, but that's okay, because you-